Genesis 26.
Okay, let's read from verse 1. The Bible says there was a famine in the land besides the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went to Abimelech, king of the Philistines, in Gerar. Then the Lord appeared to him and said, "Do not go down to Egypt. Live in the land of which I shall tell you. Dwell in this land, and I will be with you and bless you.
Amen.
For you and your descendants, I will give all these lands, and I will perform the oath which I swore to Abraham your father. I will make your descendants multiply as the stars of heaven, and I will give to your descendants all these lands. And in your seed, all the nations of the earth shall be blessed."
Amen.
"Because Abraham obeyed my voice and kept my charge, my commandments, my statutes, and my laws, so Isaac dwelt in Gerar." There's something that I wanted us to look at it there, verse 7.
Verse 7.
"And the man," can you see the verse there? "And the man of the place asked about his wife."
Amen.
"And he said, 'She's my sister.' For he was afraid to say, 'She's my wife,' because he thought, 'Lest the man of the place kill me for Rebekah, because she is beautiful to behold.'"
Amen.
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
God wants us to be blessed.
Modimo nyaka gore re shofale.
God
ngwalang jwalo
wants us to be blessed.
Modimo rata re shofale.
In other words, blessing is your portion.
So ura uri dichufa tshuke karolo ya rena.
But blessing, you must know, they don't come very quick the way you think.
Mara tsebang dichufa tsha diteka pela pela ka mogore nana.
When we have read, we can see that before the blessing comes,
before the chufa to defeat,
number one thing that will come is a famine.
Ntoya matomo yetangi ibatlala.
Famine must come first.
Tlala isunchuri itle pele.
Number two,
sabubedi,
God's direction will come.
Tsupatsela e tswang modimo itlotla.
Look here, if you read here, you will see that the first thing was, okay, this famine.
Ha o ka lebella mota tlo re ntwe mathomothomo ke tlala.
So that when the famine comes,
tlala
the question will be, what is it that we are supposed to do?
Taba taba ya no ngri diang.
So the person that must be asked that kind of a question is God.
Motho a botsisha ngpotsisha ye wehe ke modimo.
So in other words, famine provokes God's direction.
Tlala e shishinya tshopatsela e tswang modimo.
If we want to get out from famine, we must know what God is saying with us.
Ha re nyoko tswa ka ratala re tsontsho kwa re tsebe semodimo re bojang sona.
The scripture that we have read here, they say,
le ngwalo le re dibaleng mo le re,
this was not the first famine.
Ne ne isitala ya mathomo.
So in other words, every generation faced their own famine.
Ora le loko le le loko ne le kopana le tala ya lona.
This was the second generation from Abraham, because
yene letala ya bobedi a re tswa ko
Abraham. Abraham also faced his own
fate. Ka re Abraham le yena o kopane le ha yetala.
When we read it, the Bible says,
ha re bala mo Bible re,
this famine came first by the time of Abraham.
E le ya tapili kanako ya Abraham.
But look at this scripture, it says,
mara lebelang lengwalo le botsana le re,
this other one was a nightmare. This one.
E re ye yona.
It says, verse 1, it says, there was a famine in the land.
And it
says, besides the first
famine
that was in the days of Abraham. Your father faced famine.
We have to face
famine. Our children must face
famine.
But unless we get direction from God,
we
stay in our famine. So here it shows that Isaac asked God. Because Because for you to be blessed, you need to ask God.
You cannot
be blessed anywhere. There's a place where God wants you to be. And the instruction was, don't live where you are. If you go to Egypt, Egypt is a land of slavery, you'll be slaves. Our God doesn't want us to be slaves, He wants us to be blessed. Our God doesn't want us to be slaves, He wants us to be blessed. I'm sorry to tell you that some of your jobs you are doing, you're working, is slavery. If you don't work, you lose everything you have. Don't ever give a testimony that you are blessed with a job. If you say that, you are in Egypt. In Egypt, you are supposed to be a slave. You work for others. You left with strides of life. In Egypt, you don't possess the land. Can you see why many people are working? They cannot have lands. Okay, the third thing here is the promise. God said, if you obey, I will never allow you to be poor. You'll be blessed. Not only you, even your children will have lands. If you obey and stay in
Gerar,
I will bless you. Blessings must follow the children of
Abraham.
I don't know if you're hearing that. You can see there here that this was Isaac. But this Isaac, if you can continue reading. Don't worry if I can tell you this, but
Bible says,
after now he dwell, he had one thing. Without the promises of God being fulfilled, one thing he had was his wife. And the wife was beautiful to behold. A blessed man must have a beautiful wife. I mean, tell you, a blessed man must have a beautiful wife. If you want to see you're not blessed, look at your wife. Because I'll tell you why. Because when it's no issue of, you know, you have to be visibly beautiful. There are things that makes wife beautiful. Your wife represents you. The moment money comes, you will see your wife. She will get crayon. You will start to see her nails now. You cannot do that. You cannot change your, I mean, you will see her hairs. When money, now, this man, he had beautiful, he loved his wife. But he forced to say, no. My wife, this time, the way you're beautiful. No, everybody is looking at you. You are my sister. So you could see they have to communicate like his sister.
But somehow you cannot
do that forever.
So that's what happened.
The people of Philistine found this man is lying to us. And then even Abraham did. In other words, Isaac was going through what Abraham went through.
Then
the generational curse of lying. So that generational curse of lying was going hand in hand with the famine they were going through. But he stood in the promises.
Jalong yena ema mo di tshepiso.
And he had this beautiful wife, which was commended to the king. This wife, if she can be taken by the king, she will represent the king. Today, I'm sorry to tell you that, but I have to tell you.
A stingy
man,
eh?
And a poor man are the same. But a man who's blessed will take care of his wife. Tell your neighbor. If you are blessed, your wife will enjoy what you have. I want to pray so that God will bless you.